Get it. Yes.
A very useful command for someone with limited ability to grasp an object is to have the dog rest its head on the partner's lap while holding the object firmly. The partner must have a good grasp of the object before giving the command for the dog to release the object, and the dog must wait for the cue.
Give. Nice.
You asking me took your attention off of him, and so he's doing a click and treat. You know, and so like sometimes you've got to like almost ignore them to where they want to keep trying.
For rest.
Yeah. And then I would say good. Good rest.
Okay.
Good rest.
You mean while
He's resting.
While he's resting before I click?
Okay. To reinforce what he's doing.
Clicking to signify the end of that behavior.
Good rest. Now, good rest.
Okay. And then you just have to, like, sometimes...
Thank you.
If he'll stay in the game, if he lifts his head and then puts it back down, that's good. If he gets to where he gets out of it, like he's popping up all the time, then you just shorten the time of it.
Everything you want. It's just in his eyeballs. Wrong? Court rest.
I would do it once without your hand in the treat bag.
Yes, that's okay.
Like put it like just on the side or something. Like the treat bag can stay where it is, just don't have your hand in it.
Gosh, I know.
So that he doesn't treat it. He offered what, two behaviors before he offered rest. So if you let the time elapse too long, he's going to offer a different behavior because he's not sure of what it is.
So like if he pushing offers, it as long as I thought he
So if he offers the wrong behavior and then the right behavior, make it a shorter time frame to where he really understands that's the behavior you want it. And then when he offers it right away, then add duration.
Okay.
Good boy.
Corporate rest as accessible.
Okay.